100 parts to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One part He has bestowed on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the reason a mother will love a child. A wild animal will love its offspring. A brother will love a sister. A sister will love a brother. Because of this one part of the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved 99 parts for the believers yawm al-qiyamah. 99 parts. He has saved for us on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And there's another beautiful hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated by Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. That some prisoners, they came to Madinah Munawwara, and the companion saw a woman looking for her child. And then when this mother, this woman, when she found her child, she began to feed the child. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, pointing towards that woman, that a mother, said to the companions, do you think the mother would ever put her child into fire, into the hellfire? The companions said, no, it's not possible. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O companions, Allah is more merciful upon His servants than a mother is to her child. Allah is more merciful upon us than our own mothers. And this is the reason that the companions alayhim salam, the awliya radiallahu ta'ala majma'een, and the Muslims of the past, regardless of the sins they committed, they knew that there's only one door, that is the door of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If everyone rejects you, if everyone taunts you, ridicules you, dishonors you. But one thing to remember, there's only one. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you turn to Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept you. Do you know a great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Sayyidina Bishr Hafi radiallahu ta'ala, probably you heard this before. Sayyidina Bishr Hafi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, before he repented, before he became a close servant of Allah, from the close servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was known to be a drunkard, an alcoholic. He used to consume alcohol every single day of his life. One day, what happened? Now look, mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive you. And you know, the ulama, they have stated the mercy of Allah is looking for excuses to forgive you. You take one step towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's mercy will come running towards you. Bishr Hafi radiallahu ta'ala anhu once was walking the streets of Baghdad. He was in a state of under the influence of alcohol. He was walking when he saw a piece of paper that had the name Allah written on it. He was walking and then he saw this piece of paper. He was a Muslim end of the day. Had respect for the name of Allah. So what he did, he picked up that piece of paper. He kissed that piece of paper. He looked into his pocket. He found 1 dinar. He went to a shop. He bought some perfume itr. He applied some itr on a piece of paper. And he placed that paper on between two walls. Out of adab. And then he went to his house. That night, the Imam of Baghdad, the Sheikh of Baghdad, he saw a dream. An unseen voice telling to him, wake up. Go to the house of Bishr and inform Bishr that Allah has forgiven his sins. This Imam, he woke up and was thinking about last night. Yesterday I was going past his house. There he was with his friends. He had women singing in his house. They were drinking alcohol, they were singing, they were enjoying, they were committing sins. This must be a false dream, just an imagination. So he went back to sleep. Again, he saw the same dream the second time. The third time, when he saw the dream the third time, he knew this must be a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he went, he prayed two rak'at, and then he went to the house of Bishr, he knocked on the door. Bishr Hafi was a very rich person. He had a servant, he opened the door. To his amazement, he saw a skull in front of the house of Bishr Hafi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So he said, "What can I do for you?" He said, "Go to Bishr and inform him I have a message for him from Allah." And the servant went, running into the house of Bishr. Bishr, you know, he was laughing, giggling and dancing with his friends. When a servant whispered this into his ear, "Oh Bishr, there is an imam outside your door. He has a message for you from Allah." As soon as he heard this, he went out running. Even forgot to wear his shoes, his sandals. He came out running. He went outside. He kissed the hands of the Shaykh and said, "Shaykh, what made you come here? What has brought you here?" He said, "I don't know what you did last night, but I saw a dream three times, an unseen voice telling me to wake up, to come to you, to inform you that Allah has forgiven all of your sins." He informed, he said, "Yo Shaykh, yes, I remember that thing. And that was, I saw a name of Allah written on the ground. I picked it up and respected that piece of paper because it had the name of Allah. Verily, this must be the reason why Allah has forgiven my sins. Oh Shaykh, I repent on your hands. From today, I will never go towards evil." From that moment, he never went towards alcohol, music, and dancing. And do you know his name now became Bishr Hafi? What's the meaning of half? Half is mafail, a person who is without shoes, barefoot. From the moment he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till his last breath, he never wore shoes. And what was the karama? What was the honor Allah gave him? That he used to walk on the streets of Baghdad without shoes. The honor Allah bestowed him, no animal would urinate in the streets of Baghdad. A man was going past and he saw a farmer was going past with a flock of sheep in the streets of Baghdad. To his amazement, so many years he saw the sheep urinating in the streets of Baghdad. He looked towards the heavens and said, "Inna lillahi wa inna raji'un." It seems as if Bishr Hafi has passed away. He ran quickly to the house and he saw that Bishr Hafi had passed away. You see, la taqnatu min rahmatillah. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.